Okay, this is a basic introduction to MEO, which stands for Magnetically Enhanced Output. Basically, this is what we have here are two rotors that are connected together by this link, this common link bar right here. You can see when one turns, the other one turns, and each one has two sets of magnets in it. This is negative pole facing out, and then down here is positive pole facing out, and the other side is the opposite. You got positive on the top, negative on the bottom. And what this does is that by this switching back and forth, it can take a piston, such as this one here. This one has no magnets in it, where you would have a magnet here and a magnet here, each with opposite poles facing out. So the polarity is all facing one direction. And that rides in this tube right here. And what happens is these magnets force this piston back and forth. So it's always being pushed from one end while it's being pulled toward the other. So as the magnet increases its distance and thus decreases the force from the magnet pushing it, it decreases its distance and increases its force with the magnet pulling it. And then once it gets down there, it will move back in the other direction. This is controlled by these infrared brake beam sensors right here. And I'll switch this on so we can see it in operation. So you can see as I brake the beam, it switches. And it runs on 6 volts at 1.6 amps or 9.6 watts. And it's intermittent. It only runs when it switches. And it takes about 2/10 of a second that it uses the full 9.6 watts. And the rest of the time it's just a maintenance voltage that holds these in place. Which you can see the maintenance voltage is very low, less than a watt. Alright, so let me turn that back off here. Now, this is all operated, and there's a tape measure there so you can see scale. This whole assembly, which is the actual prime mover, is approximately 10 inches long. So this is very small scale. We're using pretty small magnets here. What this runs is this servo right here. Let me turn it back on. So you can see that's all it's running. It's that servo right there. So it only uses power when it moves the servo. It's controlled. These brake beam sensors are controlled by this Arduino Uno. And it gets its power from this little tablet USB, and it's microwatts, it's negligible. And the power from the DC power supply is supplying the power to the servo. So that's all it is. Okay, and what we're running with this is through these connector arms, that the piston has a hole in the center of it, and this gets a shaft that goes through the piston and then transfers the piston energy to these transfer arms. And it's running just a regular crank and link here that's connected to a crankshaft. And on that crankshaft are mounted two flywheels. These are 3D printed, lead filled. This one weighs 8 pounds. The one on the back weighs 8.4 pounds. And then here we have a different kind of flywheel with a gear on it. It has a 210 tooth gear on it. And this flywheel weighs 3/4 of a pound. So altogether we have 17.14 pounds of weight on this crankshaft. And then that large gear, that 210 tooth gear, is running this small DC generator that has a 20-tooth gear on it. You can see right there. So it's a little bit over 10 to 1 gear ratio, where this will turn 10 times for every one time this turns. And that's basically it. So let me go ahead and put a magnetized piston in this, set this down. I'll go ahead and put a magnetized piston in this and we'll start it up and you can see what it does. Magnets in it, and then the magnets in that. Let's get this put on here. So if this is centered, it will basically hold the piston in the center, equidistant in the middle of those two. Let me explain a couple things here before I start this up. One thing I forgot to mention, we do have a load on this DC generator, which is just this board of LEDs. So it's a pretty small load, but that's not the important part. The important part is how the load interacts with the prime mover, or how the prime mover interacts with the load and the effect they have on each other. So one thing to keep in mind, what is powering all of this is just the interaction of these magnetic fields right here. All this powers is the servo. So no matter what the power output is here, it's not determined by this. It's predetermined by the strength of the magnets in the assembly, the size of the magnets. And these are small, very small scale here, but this is a very substantial load. Like I said, a little bit over approximately 17.14 pounds, and they are running with the load of the generator, which had a small load. It's a very small load, but it's a load nonetheless. Like I said, the amount of the load isn't that important. It's how the interaction works. The amount of power actually being used is determined by how fast and how often, not how fast, but how often this activates the servo. And here's the interesting part. We can actually use time as a mechanical advantage. So the larger the load we put on this, the slower this will run and the less often this will activate. So the less power it's using, but the power output remains the same. It remains constant. Because like I said, it's determined by the force of the magnets. So the slower we get this moving back and forth, it's still exerting the same amount of force, but we have put so much weight on it that it's causing it to move extremely slow. So the input happens less often. So let me start this up, and I can pretty much guarantee you that this will not self-start. Because this load is very large, chances are I'll have to give it a little bit of a push to get it started. But once it's running, I can actually turn the power down even farther. So let's start this up. Yeah, see, it don't want to start. So we'll give it a little push. It is lighting up the LED, it's kind of hard to see. Oh, the light. See, it is lighting them up. Okay, and you can see the servo activating there. And you can see on the power. It actually only uses the full 9.6 watts for about 0.2 of a second, And right now the RPM is about 34 or 35 RPM. Let's see here. It's actually going a little bit faster than it normally does. Yeah, it's going about 42 RPM. So that's it. And you can see I can slow it down even farther. So you can see it's only activating about actually less than once a second there. But you can see the piston is still being forced its full length of travel. So imagine that if these were magnets the size of a bar of soap, which is capable of over 1,000 pounds of linear torque doing it that way. So imagine if we had over 1,000 pounds of force working there. That's moving extremely slow, but it's running a very large generator. With 1,000 pounds of force, you could run a very large generator. But through gearing, the generator could be spinning at hundreds or many hundreds of RPM, while this is taking possibly seconds, a couple seconds, because with that larger magnet, we'd have a much larger stroke. But it's under so much force because it's turning this huge load of a very powerful generator. Just imagine what we could do with that. So let me turn this off, because there's something else that I want to point out here. Okay, with the rotors, they switch back and forth to push and pull, to push and pull. And the interesting thing, we have them attached to one servo with this connecting bar. And the interesting thing is the rotor switching from push to pull will self-align because it is being influenced by this magnet here, or this one here, depending on which side it is. But whichever side is switching to attract instead of repel will self-align. So it actually helps with the force needed to move the magnet that's switching from attract to repel. So that's another reason why it would take such a small amount of power to run this. Okay, and again, this was just a basic introduction to MEO. And again, it's magnetically enhanced output. And it will also run pretty fast. Let me take part of the load off of it. In fact, we'll start it up here. We started from a dead stop. Now it still has the physical load of the flywheels and the generator. It's just that there's no longer a load on the generator. So we'll turn it on, and you can see how fast it spins up with just using just the force of the magnet. Oh, a second, got it. Make sure I get this right here. Okay, also notice there's a hand crank on here. That's so it can be cranked by hand so that you can actually feel the amount of force that it takes to run this load. And it's substantial. It's definitely more than 9.6 watts for 0.2 of a second once every, it's actually over one time or less than one time per second. Or no, it would be a little bit over because it does activate twice per RPM. When it's running, it usually runs at like 35 RPM. But anyway, this was just a basic introduction to MEO, MEO. Thank you.